Hi, Joe Alton, MD here, also known as Dr. Bones of doomandbloom.net, where you'll find over 1,000 articles, videos, and podcasts on medical preparedness for any disaster. I'm also the co-author of the Book Excellence Award winner in medicine, The Survival Medicine Handbook, the essential guide for when medical help is not on the way, the brand new book, Alton's Antibiotics and Infectious Disease, The Layman's Guide to Available Antibacterial in Austere Settings, and the designer of an entire line of medical kits at store.doomandbloom.net. We're in beautiful Gatlinburg, Tennessee, gateway to the Great Smoky Mountains National Park, right over my shoulder. You can't believe how beautiful this place is. This is a special report on kissing bugs. No, not kissing bugs, as in how to kiss bugs. I mean kissing bugs, an invasive species from south of the border that is now found here in Tennessee and as far north as Pennsylvania and Illinois. The insect in question is Triatoma sanguisuga. It's called the kissing bug because it tends to bite human and animal victims around the mouth, although sometimes it might target the eyes or other mucous membranes. It's bad enough to have to deal with the redness, itching, and swelling that goes along with insect bites, but there's more. When the kissing bug sucks your blood, it defecates or poops on your skin. Irritated victims tend to rub the poop into the bite wound while scratching the itchy areas. In kids, a swollen eyelid on one side, also called Romagna's sign, is a possible sign of infection. Even worse, in the excrement lives a parasite called Trypanosoma cruzi that lodges itself in heart, intestine, and elsewhere and causes something called Chagas disease. Most people only experience minor symptoms with this disease, but a percentage of victims may develop diarrhea and vomiting, enlargement of the liver or spleen, an increased chance of having a stroke, an enlarged heart, irregular heartbeats that can be fatal. Chagas disease is not transmitted from person to person, though, or from casual contact with infected people or animals. It can be spread, however, by infected blood products or from mother to baby during a pregnancy. Rarely, an extreme allergic reaction known as anaphylaxis, something we've talked about here before, can occur. You can avoid Chagas disease by identifying and eliminating the bug that carries it. Adult kissing bugs range from about 3/4 to 1 1/4 inches in length. Most of them, but not all, have a characteristic band around the edges of the body that is striped with orange or red markings. Their mouth parts appear as a large black extension to the head, sort of like a cone. The CDC has a set of recommendations to discourage kissing bugs. Locate outdoor lights away from dwellings, such as homes, dog kennels, and chicken coops. Turn off lights when not in use. Remove rock, wood, and trash piles from near the home. Clear out nests of birds and animals. Seal cracks or gaps around windows, air conditioners, walls, roofs, doors, and crawl spaces. Close chimney flues when not in use. And allow pets to sleep indoors, if possible. I don't know about that pet hippo of yours. Bottom line, the kissing bug exists and so does Chagas disease, but most people don't know they have it. Although 300,000 people are thought to have brought the disease in from Latin America, few cases seem to have originated in the U.S. The bug is here though, and you should know how to treat it, should know all about it. Antiparasitic treatment is most effective early in the course of infection. In the United States, the treatment with the least side effects is benznidazole. It's approved by the Food and Drug Administration, even for use in children 2 to 12 years of age, and is widely available commercially. You may get better on your own after a few weeks, but without the treatment, the infection does stay in your body. A personal experience with the kissing bug is unlikely to be in your future, but if you suspect you have Chagas disease, contact your healthcare provider immediately. This is Joe Alton, MD, that old Dr. Bones, wishing you the best of health in good times or bad. Thanks for watching. Hey, don't forget to fill those holes in your medical storage by checking out Nurse Amy's entire line of medical kits, books, and more at store.doomandbloom.net. That's store.doomandbloom.net. You'll be glad you did.